Celebrations galore at Jaipur, where the announcement was made, at the Congress headquarters in New Delhi. What most had expected, what the majority within the Congress rank and file had voiced for months, comes to life at last.
His appointment as Vice President of the Indian National Congress today, Sri Rahul Gandhi has been elevated to the number two position in the Congress party.
In every likelihood, this is Rahul Gandhi's penultimate promotion. That the formal proposal came from A.K. Antony, the number two in seniority in the government, itself speaks volumes.
It has a message has been gone clear throughout the country that now under his leadership, 2014 and 9 elections, state elections are forthcoming, will be
held. We are eager as a youth of the country to his leadership, to his capability, his maturity, his sagacity.
There's no doubting the huge positives for the party. Rahul brings with him a stature as a Gandhi scion that frequently draws automatic clout, at least in the Congress ranks. Then he's clean of the baggage that UPA 1 and UPA 2 carry. And thirdly, he's a draw for the youth vote.
He's better than the older people who are really working here in the
politics. It's all older people are there. I think Rahul Gandhi should be one of them. I mean, he should be the one.
No missing out on the huge implications either. At the top, he's shouldering responsibility beyond the name tag. Rahul Gandhi is to be the face of the party for 2014, or perhaps earlier, going by the timing of the announcement. It could also mean a rejig in intra-party and intra-UPA equations, while nudging the BJP to announce its strategy. To be clarified, Rahul Gandhi is not the Congress's prime ministerial candidate, at least for now. Which leads us to the question, the Congress may well gain from Rahul Gandhi's elevation, but will it be the party that lets him down? Bureau Report, News 6.